On? Am I on? Good evening. Well, you guys respond better that way. Do you know that? You can actually hear me. It's good to have you all out tonight. I know we're here for the Christmas concert tonight, for the kids' Christmas concert, and I'm looking forward to seeing it all. Believe it or not, when they all came up and we were in the library back here, they were quiet. And some of you might not believe that, but maybe it's nerves. I don't know what it is, but they were quiet until I started asking them questions. And then they started getting a little bit loud. But thank you for coming out tonight. It's great to have you. I do have a couple of announcements as we get started. And I don't know where I put them, so I'm going to go right off the top of my head. Okay, and so first of all is after the concert tonight, we are going to have a cookie and milk fellowship downstairs in the fellowship hall. So everyone is invited to go downstairs for that. Please go on down, and I'd love to see you all there. But if you don't like cookies and milk, I guess I can't help you, but you can still have the fellowship. I know there's people that are lactose intolerant, is that what it's called? And sometimes, I don't know, you can listen, I know lactose intolerant people that like to eat ice cream, that's all I gotta say, okay? So you can go down, there's no ice cream anyway. You can drink milk. But, so go on down for that. Then tomorrow night, those that are in the missions committee, we have our meeting tomorrow night at 6:30. Tuesday night is the Christmas caroling. Anyone that wants to go, dinner is here at 5:30, and then you'll go caroling afterwards. But there is a sign-up sheet in the hallway, so make sure you sign up for that. And then last but not least, Tuesday, December 24th is what day? Christmas Eve. And so we always have a Christmas Eve candlelight service, but this year we're having a different kind of a Christmas Eve candlelight service. We're having a Christmas Eve candlelight communion service. Okay, so just added another word. And so plan to come out, starts at 6 o'clock on Christmas Eve, which is December 24th, right? Doesn't change like Thanksgiving does. But so Tuesday, December 24th, Christmas Eve, candlelight communion service. You're all welcome to come out and enjoy that time. And then go on for the rest of your Christmas Eve. So thanks for coming out tonight. We're going to start this evening by reading in Matthew chapter. Look, I found my announcements. Matthew chapter 1, verses 18 to 25. So if you have your Bible, I encourage you to open your Bibles to Matthew 1, 18 to 25. I'd also ask you to stand out of the respect of the reading of God's Word as we read Matthew chapter 1, verses 18 to 25. And I'll just read through all these verses by myself as we go through it. So Matthew 1, verses 18 to 25, and the Word of God says, "Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise. When as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privily. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary, thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Then Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife. And knew her not till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus." Thank you very much for the reading of God's Word. Let's remain standing as we go to the Lord in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, I do thank you. Thank you for this story that we just read, how even though it was prophesied in the book of Isaiah some 700 years prior to the birth of Christ, we can see how it all played out. And you had a specific time to play that out. And we thank you for that. Lord, I thank you for as we are celebrating the birth of Christ, for what that really means to us if we have come to know Jesus Christ as our Savior. Lord, as we're going to be singing about joy tonight, that's the best joy that could ever happen, coming to know Jesus Christ as Savior. So Lord, I pray that as we hear the kids sing and we hear them speak their parts, Lord, that we're focused on you and focused on Christ, that we're focused on Jesus and what he did for us. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Mr. Mike Dull.
Well, good evening, everyone. I invite you to take your hymn book and turn to hymn number 91. We're going to give you an opportunity to sing before the kids do. Hymn number 91, as we sing together, There's a Song in the Air.
There's a song in the air. There's a song in the sky. There's a mother's sweet prayer and a baby.
Ushers down forward. If you want to come down forward, please. We're gonna pray, and then we'll have you sit down, and then we'll take our offering and sing another song, and then watch what the kids do. So let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Lord, I thank you how you provide for us. And Lord, I thank you that we do have an opportunity to give back, not just financially. We have an opportunity to give back as we see the kids tonight giving back in singing in this concert and in maybe saying different words, different parts in this concert. We thank you for that. Lord, I pray that we give back to you throughout the rest of our life, Lord, every day of our life. Thank you for what you've given us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
We have our little ones up here, and they're going to actually do the offertory. And if you can notice, they have some bells in their hands. So if you took a good guess, the song might be Gospel Bells. So give us just a moment,
Jesus. Thank you.
Well, we're going to have some help up here with these young people. They're going to give us some help. We're going to go ahead and turn our hymn books once again to hymn number 89, and we're going to sing together a very, very timely song, very popular song this time of year, Away in a Manger, No Crib for a Bed. Hymn number 89, standing together as we sing. This time we're going to go ahead and formally announce to you the Faith Baptist Church Altoona Children and Youth Christmas program entitled The Joy of Christmas.
Let earth rejoice. Everyone looks forward to Christmas. Everything seems to be bursting with joy.
But sometimes we forget where our joy comes from.
It's not the presents, it's not the lights, it's not even making special memories with family and friends. Christmas gives us joy beyond all that.
Christmas is all about the Father's love for us. God sent His Son, Jesus. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, for whosoever believeth in Him shall not perish and have everlasting life.
When Jesus was born in Bethlehem, the angels appeared in the sky, praising God with great joy. Luke 2:10 and 11. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord.
They had the greatest news to share with the shepherds. Jesus was born!
Today we celebrate just like the angels, knowing that God is with us. Luke 2:13 and 14. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
Let heaven and nature sing, Jesus is here, that gives us the greatest joy of all.
Can you imagine how it felt that night when Jesus arrived?
After hundreds of years of waiting to hear from God, suddenly the Messiah was here.
When Jesus was born, he changed history forever. There would never be a time when God would be silent or far away because Jesus had come.
The gift of God's Son was given, not because we deserve it, but because God loves us.
So today, we can celebrate that amazing gift together, praising God for his love and faithfulness.
From the little town of Bethlehem to Altoona today, God's glory is available to all.
Thank you.
We can show the joy of Christmas in many different ways. Sometimes we sing, sometimes we dance, sometimes we do special things to serve others.
But no matter what, we have a lot of fun. Christmas is awesome!
There are so many songs we sing at Christmas. Everyone loves them, but why should we do all the singing?
It's Christmas. We sing because the Savior is born. So don't just sit there, sing along.
Thank you.
So we know God gives us joy because he loves us. We know that joy comes from Jesus, who is born to save us.
We know that joy is a gift greater than anything else we could ever receive. But here's the best part. We can share the joy of Christmas with others.
The whole world needs to know that Jesus was born to save them. But who will tell them? Mark 16:15. And he said unto them, Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature.
Sometimes it's hard to explain the joy we have in Jesus. But God gave each of us a story to tell. That's why we're here.
When we tell others the story of how Jesus saved us, we are God's most powerful messengers of the truth. This is good news.
This Christmas, share your joy, not just through presents, traditions, and special memories, but through the amazing love of Jesus.
If you do, then you will spread joy to the whole world.
One precious heart at a time.
Merry Christmas!
want to say thank you to all the kids, right? Give another hand to the kids. And don't want to forget about Miss Val and Miss Taylor. I almost forgot your name, Miss Taylor. Can you do that? To thank them. They all did a good job, didn't they? We do want to thank you for coming out really briefly. There was a passage of scripture that was read over here a couple minutes ago, about 30 minutes ago, Luke 2, 10 and 11. I want to read that real quickly because that's where we really see the joy of Christmas. And it's actually said to us, it doesn't say the joy of Christmas, but joy is there. And it says, And the angels said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And so that's the great joy. I'm bringing you good tidings of great joy. Really, I'm bringing you good news of great joy. And so then the question is, what can that good news of great joy be? And as we're looking at this good news of great joy, we think about babies being born. We celebrate Jesus being born on December 25th. That's what Christmas is. That's what we say. Jesus was born then. That's the day we celebrate Christmas. And that's what we're looking at. But it wasn't any old baby. There is joy when babies are born. Mostly, and, you know, sometimes they look at us, you know, maybe my parents looked at me and didn't have as much joy, I don't know. But, you know, they had had twin boys 15 months before me, so I came out, oh, another boy 15 months later, right? Anyway, no, so I think they had joy. Anyway, I've brought joy to their life since then. Right, Mom? Anyway, so, but we think it's a joyous occasion, but this baby was different. Because this baby was joy that the whole world could celebrate in. And that's what we're seeing here in these verses. It's great joy. And it's not just because a baby was being born. You go down into the next verse and you see in chapter 11, it says, For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And that's the key to the joy there, that a Savior was born. The people in Israel had been waiting for their Messiah. Their Messiah had been prophesied. And so this day, as we see Christ being born, they had great joy because their Messiah was being born. Now, they didn't know it at the time, and we see as it goes through, and at this point in time, the angels are talking to the shepherds, and then the shepherds go, and then the word starts getting out, but there's great joy because the Messiah is born. And that's what we need to really understand. And the fact is that the Messiah wasn't just born for the Jews. We all have the opportunity to celebrate that great joy. And we all have the opportunity of being able to celebrate the joy of Christmas. And what does that come down to? That comes down to knowing Jesus Christ as Savior. If you have come to know Jesus Christ as Savior at some point in your life, then Christmas is great joy. Because we look back and we say, yes, we're celebrating our Savior being born. And that's the best joy that we could ever think of, our Savior being born. But if you have not come to know Jesus Christ as Savior, then you really have no joy except for maybe whatever joy you get out of opening whatever gift you're going to open on Christmas Day that maybe a couple weeks later you're going to forget that you even got, or a couple years, depending on what the present is. Because it does not have an eternal joy, whereas the gift of Jesus Christ has an eternal joy. The gift of Jesus Christ changes where you can go for eternity, whether you're going to go to hell or heaven. All mankind is destined for hell. Why? Because of sin. We can go back to Genesis 3 and we read the story of Adam and Eve and how they sinned in the garden. At that point, mankind was separated from God for eternity. You know how long eternity is? It's forever. That's all we can say, right? We really don't understand the concept of eternity because everything we run on has time. Sometimes we call, you know, a long time eternity. That's not even close to eternity. But it's forever, separated from God for eternity in hell, and then hell's going to be thrown into the lake of fire, all because of sin. But if we go to Ephesians chapter 2, and Ephesians chapter 2 says it clearly, but God. It says, but God. You see, God stepped in the first In the first three verses of Ephesians 2, we see mankind's state and how they're a sinful state. But then we get down to verse 4 and it says, but God who is rich in mercy, but God who has great love, with his great love wherewith he loved us, but God stepped in and he provided us this baby that we celebrate at Christmas time, Jesus Christ. He didn't provide it for us. He came down on this earth himself. Not just to be a baby and to live life, but to go to the cross and to die. And not just to die, but to rise again 3 days later. You see what that does? The whole concept of the death, the burial, and the resurrection overcomes death, which means it overcomes sin. Jesus had to die to prove that he had power over sin. If he would have never rose again, he could never forgive sins because he never had the power over sin. But he does because he rose again. And that's why we can have great joy. You want to have great joy this Christmas? Make sure you know Jesus Christ as Savior. That's how you can have great joy. And there's no better time than to come to know Jesus Christ as Savior as the Christmas season. If you do know Christ as Savior, you already have that joy. Go spread it with other people. Go tell it on the mountain. That's what the kids sang, right? Joy to the world. Let's do it, okay? Let's spread our joy to everybody. And if you want to know anything about that joy, please see one of us after this service. We'd love to talk about that joy with you if you don't have that joy. But understand, it all comes down to this baby Jesus who lived this life, died on the cross, rose again 3 days later so that he can forgive our sins. And then, we go from having that eternal state separated from God in hell and the lake of fire to being able to spend eternity with God, to be able to call God Dad because we're part of his family. That's what this great joy is. That's why we should celebrate Christmas more than any other thing. That's why we should celebrate Christmas. And that's what we're here for today. I'm going to go ahead and pray. I'm going to call Mr. Mike up. We're going to sing one more hymn, hymn number 104. Then I want to remind you, maybe Mr. Mike can, I'm missing Mr. Mike right now. There he is. Okay. Maybe Mr. Mike then can come, can lead us in prayer for the refreshments downstairs. Everybody's invited to come. But listen, if you don't have that great joy yet, please make sure you see somebody here at the church so we can share that joy with you. And then you can have that great joy throughout the rest of this Christmas season. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Lord, I thank you for this time of the year, this time where we get to celebrate Christ's birth. Lord, I pray that as we do celebrate the gift of Jesus Christ, and that's what it is, it's a gift, that we understand he was born as a baby. He had to be born like a human. But Lord, there was only one reason he came down to this earth, and that was to die on the cross and rise again. And we thank you for that work, that you loved us enough to send Jesus to die on the cross for us. Lord, I pray that each and every person here would come to know Jesus Christ as a Savior before we die here on this earth, so that we can then go and spend eternity with you. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Open your hymnals, if you could, to hymn number 104, How Great Our Joy.
Stand together as we sing.
While by the sheep we watched as